So guys, now we are going to study a very important topic that is called bleeding disorders. See, many of us have lot of confusion from bleeding disorders. It includes many things. First one, idiopathic thrombotic purpura or thrombocytopenic purpura. There is one thing called, that is called IDP. Second one, TTP. What is TTP? Thrombocytopenic purpura. There is something called HUS. HUS means hemolytic uremic syndrome. There is something called DIC. DIC means disseminated intravascular coagulation. All these four are important. Usually we all confuse in the exam to choose which option. Disseminated intravascular coagulation. See, what is the problem? Everywhere you will have bleeding time will be more. You will have more bleeding time. You will be bleeding for more time. No clotting is occurring. Bleeding time more. So how you differentiate? Idiopathic is very easy. From the word only, idiopathic. They will give you a question, a baby is bleeding. What is the reason? No reason. They give a big paragraph and they say something. No reason for bleeding. Babies, they are brushing. And bleeding from gum bleeding. No other reason, nothing is given. So bleeding without any reason. Always go for idiopathic. If you see bleeding without any reason, you don't know the reason. So what is it? Idiopathic means no one knows. So always go for which answer? Idiopathic thrombotic purpura. Remember here, there is no cell seen. Nothing is seen. Normally in all these conditions, we will see hemolysis cell. There is no cell seen. Just bleeding. No one knows the reason. Next one, TTP. TTP means thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. Remember here, there is a gene defect here. That is called ADAM-ST13G. The gene defect is ADAM-ST13G. To understand what is ADAM-ST13, normally if this is my blood vessel, there is a high chance of von Willebrand factor to come and accumulate. It will cause clotting and can lead to bleeding. Right? Normally, ADAM-ST13 gene come here and they clean von Willebrand factor, VWF factor. They will clean it. Who will clean it? ADAM-ST13 gene. But in thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, this gene is defective. So can they clean? No cleaning. So what will occur? Accumulation of von Willebrand factor, increase in von Willebrand factor. There is no degradation. There is no avoiding. So all the von Willebrand factor and they accumulate and they cause what? Clotting, and that leads to what? Bleeding. So remember, ADAM-ST13 gene problem cause increase in von Willebrand factor. Remember, there is a PENDAR symptoms here. PENDAR means 5 symptoms. Remember a mnemonics, ART, that is triad. One is anemia, hemolytic anemia will be there. Second thing, R for renal failure. In the question, they give you renal problem. If renal problem means, you will have more creatinine. In the question, they will give you, baby have more creatinine. T for thrombocytopenia. Platelets will have problem. So these are the 3 symptoms, ART, triad. Plus, here the patient will have PENDAR symptom. PENDAR means 5 symptoms. 3 is this one. Plus, patient will have fever. Patient will have neurological symptoms like confusion, headache. So remember, along with the thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, think 5 symptoms. One is anemia, hemolytic anemia, R for renal failure, creatinine will be increased, T for thrombocytopenia, platelet will be decreased. Remember, you will see a specific type of cells here. Wherever you see hemolysis, you will see schistiocytes. Schistiocytes. So what you see in the microscope, or they will give you in the question, schistiocytes are seen. Think about thrombotic, thrombocytopenic purpura. Now, next one, HUS. HUS is caused by a toxin called Shiga toxin. It's coming from a bacteria. Which bacteria? E. coli, not Shigella, E. coli, specifically 0157H7, antigen number 0157H7. So, HUS is caused by Shiga toxin. They come from E. coli 0157H7. They will cause hemolysis. They will cause these three symptoms. We give the mnemonics, ART here. Here also ART, but no PENDAN. A for anemia, R for renal failure, T for thrombocytopenia. Again, here they will give you E. coli, a child traveled, bloody diarrhea child will have, bloody diarrhea, along with the bleeding, bloody diarrhea. Child traveled, he ate burger, he ate mayonnaise, he ate cheese, they come from cheese, traveled. So this type of thing they will give in the question. Remember, triad and Shiga toxin, E. coli and this one, bloody diarrhea. Here they will have PENDA, fever and neurological symptom. So how you differentiate? This here is PENDA, here is triad symptoms. Last one is DIC. In any question you see everything increased, bleeding time increased, prothrombin time increased, partial thromboplastin time increased, everything increased, sure they are talking about DIC. There is one more specific indicator, you will see D-dimer in the blood. D-dimer. In DIC, you will see D-dimer. One more thing, in DIC, fibrinogen will be decreased. The amount of fibrinogen will be decreased. Remember, bleeding time is increased, prothrombin time is increased, partial thromboplastin time is increased. Everything increased in DIC, and you will see a protein called what? D-dimer. And what about fibrinogen? Fibrinogen is decreased. Remember, DIC always comes with the sepsis. They comes with a snake bite. They comes with a trauma. They comes with a surgery. They comes with a pregnancy. So these are some precipitating factors for DIC. So once again, briefing, we are talking about bleeding disorders here. They usually give high yield three topics and they will confuse us. Idiopathic thrombotic purpura, that is idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. Problem with the platelets. Idiopathic means no reason. Brushing, bleeding. What is the reason? No one knows. In the question, nothing will be given. Remember, thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. Bleeding time is increased. The problem is in the gene, ADAMST13 gene. Normally, they will clean VWF. If gene is affected, no cleaning. So, in the blood, you will see increased VWF, that is one bilirubin factor, or there is no degradation here. There will be PENDAR of symptoms, ART, anemia, renal failure, thrombocytopenia. In the anemia, you will see schistiocytes. Here also you can see the cells, okay, in schistiocytes are seen in all hemolysis, because here also schistiocytes, in DIC also you will see schistiocytes, only in idiopathic we don't see schistiocytes, and remember there is fever and neurological symptoms, that is why PENDAR, 3 plus 2, PENDAR, 5 symptoms, HUS means hemolytic uremic syndrome, caused by Shiga toxin, E. coli 0157H7. Remember, bloody diarrhea, traveling, eating some food, ART already here, and they will see schistiocyte. Last one, DIC, disseminated intravascular coagulation. Remember, this is only bleeding disorder where bleeding time is increased, prothrombin time is increased, partial thrombopoietin time is increased. What you see as marker, D-dimer, and fibrinogen will be decreased. Think about sepsis, snake bite, trauma, surgery, pregnancy. They always come with what? DIC. So that's all are the high yield topics from bleeding disorder you have to remember for your lifetime. Thank you.